When you think of living the dream, what comes to mind? Receiving gifts from punishing politicians, perhaps? Maybe long lunches or long afternoons by the pool? Well, Kieran Boyle reckons he's living the dream, fishing for cray on the notorious Cook Strait.
As Tamati Remedy Sprite explains in the first of a new series, the school dropout can't wait to get out of bed every morning, even though the alarm goes off at 3:30 a.m.
The old saying goes, early to bed, early to rise.
3:30, mate. You do this every morning?
Every day.
Go out fishing, make up lies.
El Capitan, where are we off to, Chief?
Palliser Bay. Live in paradise that it is.
Before Wellington City wakes up, the moon's still high in the sky, Kieran Boyle has already started his beautiful day.
Is this fun? Yeah. Adrenaline pumping, eh? You definitely know you're awake.
45 knot gusts, choppy season, dangerous tides. He and his deckhand are hunting Cook Strait gold.
We're quite generous on here. We're giving away free airplane tickets to China. All crustaceans welcome. It's all timing. Timing it with the tide, timing it with the weather.
Yeah.
Everything. And those that know me, I'm the most unpunctual person you ever come across. When it comes to fishing, I'm there on time.
It goes without saying, it's tough work.
Our heaviest pot can probably weigh about just over 100 kilos.
And how many pots have you got out?
We've got 75 in today. Our whole entire day is dictated by Mother Nature, and she's nasty.
Well, what's your favourite part about fishing?
Going home for a bacon egg pie.
And cray fishing isn't the most profitable business to be in.
Our prices will change between the US dollar and how strong it is, and the demand in China and other fish being caught around the world. So we get paid per kilo on what price the crayfish factory can get for us.
But he's been dreaming about this since he first picked up a rod.
Pretty much when I was 15, I want to be a commercial fisherman on the Cook Strait.
Didn't you draw your business plans at school?
Yeah, so I always sat at the back of the classroom. Instead of, like, you know, people were like drawing pictures and that sort of thing, I was writing out business plans to see, like, oh, is this going to be viable?
After 15 years working as a deckhand, his dream is a reality.
Are you glad you kind of took that life decision pretty early and threw yourself in the deep end?
Yeah, well, I always knew that I was going to be doing fishing and nothing else. That's all I've wanted to do.
Yeah. You reckon you're living the dream?
Yeah. Ah, this is the dream. What more do you want? Like, you drive the boat, get to get covered in sea spray, and you get to see some crayfish and be exhausted at the end of the day.